Hi everyone, it's Peter from PS Sound, and this is going to be a quick video walking around this build that came for a tuning session. We can say it's an OEM plus upgrade. No, it's an OEM upgrade because up front everything is in factory locations, and this platform is great. We love Mercedes for what they've done with the speaker locations. You can get great results out of them, but there's some addition to the system here, and actually maybe you have to explain it to me. Come on, let's show people what you've done. Because you built this, didn't you?
Yeah, we saw the space. It seemed an obvious fit for a down-firing thin 12. So it's a JL TW3.
It's probably only like 4 inches deep. Yeah, it's pretty thin, but it plays really well.
Yeah, it's about, I think, just shy of 20 liters.
Mm-hmm. We have nice brackets holding it in place.
Yeah, I didn't want to be killed by it, so.
Well, especially with a V8 engine in it. So that's the addition to what's up front, and you have speakers actually in the C pillars as well as in the rear doors, but those work on the same channel, right?
Yeah.
And can we get this one out? So that's where you fitted a Helix V8 running front doors, there's two channels because they run semi-active. And then you have two channels for firewall mid bass. Then you also have rear fill, an extra two channels, but the rear doors and the C pillars are same channel, right?
Yeah.
And then we have center fill as well. So this way we use 7 channels out of the 8. There's one spare channel. We should use that for something. Come on.
Chimes.
Yep. Oh, actually, we have to test that. And you have an extra amplifier down there, an extra Audison small monoblock for the sub. So this way most people would think that this is all factory, because in every single door, actually that's locked now, but up front it's all factory location. So it looks like it's Burmeister, but it's not. So this car has most integration with, which box do you have, the Helix?
The nav
TV, the original.
Yeah.
Well, technically it's the same thing. So it uses the integration, giving optical output, and then you have absolutely full integration. USB is playing currently, lossless files, but it has Android Auto and everything. And now, after a proper tune, this system is singing nicely. Although up front we have upgraded drivers, we have the match plug and play mid bass drivers in the firewall each side, and now you have, and it went off again, and you have the ground zero mid and tweet.
Yeah.
And as people know, if I like something I say that, and if I don't like something I say that too. I wasn't a big fan of this ground zero plug and play option, because this system truly needed the rear feel and the center feel to bring this system alive. With this ground zero option, it was just lifeless. We tuned it as good as possible. Response left and right was balanced out, time, everything. And the system was technically correct, but there's just no dynamics in the speakers, no extension on the top end. It's possibly the factory speakers could have resulted in a better end result. So there are many upgrade options for mid and tweet. This is certainly not my favorite, but as I say, with the rear feel, the system came alive, and the center feel too, because Helix has center feel processing, and that helped a lot for sure. So this is just a short one for those people who possibly have Mercedes platform C-Class or E-Class. Get in contact with us, because we do lots of these. And if you want the best for your money, then you may talk to us. Because, more and more people come with these cars to us, even with systems that were installed by other shops. And for the money spent on these upgraded systems, they just don't do justice. May as well keep it factory, to be fair. Because, you know, it's not enough improvement if you have more bass in a system. That's not what it's all about. Because Yeah, at least we can show now to people the difference between the two presets before and after in this car, because it has a small controller with the Helix down there, which controls sub-level and can change preset between two savings, and then it does the trick. There you go. Let's find something that sounds nice. Eddie, can you jump to the other side? Actually, you can change preset for me just for a quick one. There you go. We will switch between presets now, because that's good fun.
If you tell me how to.
Oh yeah, you find the small little knob in the middle, you will find it.
Oh, it's the URC. I see it now.
Yeah.
Okay. And when switch. James Infirmary. Bring the light. See my baby.
So what am I doing?
Lay down all along, white
tee. Yeah, we'll leave it. So cool. That's what I came so with. So
bad. When I die, please bury me.
So originally it was very boomy, no staging.
Boxpack old man Stetson high.
After the tune, it's rock solid.
I put a $20 gold coin on my watch chain. So all the boys can see I died standing pale.
Better detailed mid-range and top end staging is sorted out, so you have proper imaging in front of you. I use this word too much, proper. I have to cut it. It takes a good 3-4 hours solid measurement, tuning, explanation, evaluation. To the time we have breakfast and lunch, it becomes a day's job. But it makes all the difference. Maybe even through the phone, that preset change doesn't really show it enough.
We'll see at home on headphones.
Exactly.
Yep.
We will also check it.
I will. Yep.
You know what? Let's go back to our song, the trumpet song. People love that. Well, we certainly do. If I find it. We have now an album for demos and whatnot. And there's everything in it. Electronic, hip-hop. There you go. Oh, well, someone is getting a phone call. So what do we do now? We reject it. Sorry. So. So after this is our preset. It's working all right. Let's change it now.
Thank you.
beautiful. So we don't know what it's gonna be like through the recording, but yes, tuning is everything. Of course, tuning cannot fix installation problems, but once it's installed properly, and actually we were happy that we didn't have to fix anything on this car, and it wasn't even installed by the shop, it was installed by the owner, and he did a good job. Everything was at the right place. I didn't have to swap any speaker cables on the DSP or change the input matching on the software. It was just correct. It just needed tuning. So, you know, props to him, because we get worse systems from shops. I was delighted to hear something that didn't sound right, but it was working fine. This is it for this short video. As I mentioned earlier, if you have a Mercedes platform, let us know. We will help you to get the best out of your system. And feel free to share it. People have to understand the importance of tuning. It is, if you have a system with a DSP and it's fully active, you must get it tuned, no matter what. Don't leave it just with basic crossovers and basic settings, because you don't know how much you're losing out on. And you may think about, you know, upgrading speakers or anything before actually you go for a tuning session. So that's the takeaway from this. Hopefully you liked it. Comment, feel free to share it, subscribe to the channel, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.
Anytime.